out of you.
No sign of forced entry. Witnesses say they saw a male neighbor come out of the apartment in the middle of the night.
Bring him in. Hello, Mr. Adams. My name is Detective John Parker. This is Lieutenant Garcia.
We have a few questions for you.
So you have already signed acknowledging that you are aware of your rights. Are you ready to move forward?
Yes, sir.
How do you know Kelly Washington?
She lives a few doors down the hall. She's been here a few months, I think. We talked to the mailbox a couple of times, but just talking and passing them.
Well, someone's done something bad to her, and we're looking to get to the bottom of it.
So you're thinking I had something to do with it?
We just want to clear a picture of what happened last night. What were you up to? Drinking? Partying?
Well, I've been home all night. I got home around 8, ate some ramen, and went to bed by 10.
Witnesses say that they saw you leaving Kelly's apartment shortly after 3 a.m. this morning.
They said you were staggering around like you were drunk. Are you sure you didn't pay Kelly a visit after a few drinks? Or were you too drunk to remember?
First of all, I don't drink. Second, I didn't leave my apartment last night. I came home, ate, and went to bed. Next thing I know, you guys are banging on my door, busting and yelling, pushing me off my couch and putting in handcuffs. Now you guys are trying to say I'm hurting someone.
Where did you sleep last night?
In my apartment, in my own bed.
So why were you on the couch when we arrived?
I think I need to speak with my attorney.
Okay, son, we'll be back.
Do you need anything to drink while you're waiting? It might be a while.
Some coffee, please.
Lawyer will be here shortly. Go ahead and have a seat. Mr. Adams, please be seated.
Aaron, did you hear what I said? Have a seat.
You need to do as he says. What's wrong with you?
Aaron, that's enough.
What are you doing? What's happening?